I, Dr. Gayatri Thimbure, from Motiola Homeopathic Medical College, from Department of Organon. So today we are going to start, which is very, very important topic in Organon, and which is the beginning of Organon of Medicine, that is the Bible of Homeopathy, aphorism number 1. So let's start with aphorism number 1. So in Bible of Homeopathy, the paragraphs has been written. In 6th edition of Organon of Medicine, there are 291 paragraphs or the section that is called as aphorisms. So in the first year, we have all learned this. So now we are starting with these paragraphs, which are very much dependent on each other. They are interlinked with each other from aphorism number 1 to 291. So why Dr. Hanuman had put these aphorisms in the number 1? What is the importance? Because previously, in the era of 17th century, Dr. Hanuman was not at all satisfied with the practice which was prevalent during Hanuman's time. He said that the medicine which was practiced was more focused on the art of physic, that is the art of drugging, rather than the physicians, the orthodox school of physicians, they were not focusing on the art of healing. They were more focusing on the art of drugging. So Hanuman was totally discontented with these prevalent practice which was held during Hanuman's time. So in the beginning of Organon of Medicine, he wrote this paragraph, that is aphorism number 1, to all the physicians in the world. It is not only for the homeopathic physician, it is for all, including allopathic, Ayurveda, Yunani, Siddha, every doctor, this paragraph is implemented to every doctor in the world. So by understanding this aphorism, we have some of the specific learning objectives, that what we are going to learn in this section or in this paragraph, that is aphorism number 1. So first of all, we are going to see who is physician. What is the meaning of the word physician? Why we are calling that a particular person as a physician? Then what are the criteria of specifically a homeopathic physician? Then what should be the most important is the mission of the physician. Next, the concept of health, disease and cure. And the last, but not the least, that is which is very important, that is meaning of sick. The person who is sick and the person who is ill, and why the person becomes sick and why we are calling sick people in the world, which is very, very important in this aphorism. So without wasting time, let's move to the aphorism number 1, paragraph number 1. That is the physician's high and only mission is to restore the sick to health, to cure as it is taught. So as we are going to start as Organon of Medicine, the first paragraph, so while understanding all paragraphs in this Bible in Organon of Medicine, we should focus on each and every word in that aphorism. Because Dr. Hanuman wrote all these paragraphs which has very deeper and deeper meaning. You know that even after 20 years, 30 years or the 50 years of practice, still the physicians, still the doctors are understanding these aphorisms for their better practice. Because you know that whatever we have learned from the ground plan of Organon, each and every aphorism is important for the practice point of view. Okay? So, aphorism number 1 is the physician's high and only mission. So, let's understand this aphorism by the understanding of each and every word in detail. So the first important is, during Hanuman's time, the medicine which was prevalent, the practice of medicine which was prevalent during Hanuman's time, it is of very dangerous. That is application of hot iron rod, or you can say the application of leeches on the persons who are diseased, or we can say the expulsion of vomiting by giving some of the emetics, or you can say the venous section. So that time, so Dr. Hanuman was not satisfied, because it is like that adding fuel into the fire. Person is already suffering, the patient is already suffering, and with these kind of practices we are giving more trouble to the patient. So that's why Dr. Hanuman wanted to, for every physician to understand what is our physician, what that every doctor should know, he should accomplish, or how he can obtain the cure in a more and more, that is without troubling to the patient. So Dr. Hanuman realized that the patient had no major benefits from these kind of practices which was prevalent during that time. So he invented in the year of 1796, that is the birth year of homeopathy, the new therapeutic system of medicine, that is homeopathy. So that is the Cinchona bark experiment, that you already know, the students, how Dr. Hanuman invented homeopathy. Okay, so now we are going to start each and every word in detail in the aphorism number 1. So the first important word in aphorism number 1 is the physician. Physician. So we are going to break this word. This word was originally derived from the Greek word, that is the physic, which means nature, or denoting that the physician has its roots in understanding the nature or the things. The physician is the one, the person who is skilled in practice, who is having skill in practice, or the physician, the person who is knowing how to cure the patient, or who is having the knowledge of art of healing. The physician is the one who is skilled in the science and the art of healing diseases, is called as physician. And preferably the homeopathic physician is the person who got his degree from the institution of homeopathy, and he can promote his, he can use his knowledge to promote the individual health and the community health by giving the homeopathic medicine to the community and to the individual person. So the physician, which is a very important word, that is the doctor. So we, in the beginning only, we should know why we are calling as a doctor, why we are calling as a physician, because we are the persons who knows the art of healing, who knows the science of medicine, who knows the practice of medicine. Now the next important words in this aphorism is hard and only. Now why Dr. Hanuman used the word hard? Because over this there cannot be any duty of the physician. It is the highest duty that we are going to perform in our life when we are going to become a physician, that is the doctor. So if one has to achieve anything, he should concentrate on his only goal. So only word Dr. Hanuman had written in an italic form when we are going to go through the actual paragraph of aphorism number 1. Why Dr. Hanuman had written that only word in italic form? Because Dr. Hanuman wanted to concentrate. It is the only thing that we are going to do in our life while curing the patient. Only mission, that is we are going to cure the disease. Okay. So goal should be always fine. It should be highest. And whenever we are, as a physician, we are going to deal with a live human being, so we should not have any negligence while handling the patients. he should focus his mind on a sick person. Yes, we are going to understand in detail what is meant by sick, but before that, the doctor's mission should be high and only. So now the next important word in this aphorism is the mission word. We should focus our attention why Dr. Hanuman had used the word mission. Why he had not used the word aim, purpose, goal or anything else? Why he had used the word mission? So yes, when we are using this word mission, at border, in military or in armies, they were doing their mission, they are completing their mission. Here also Dr. Hanuman wanted us that we should accomplish our mission. And what can be our mission? That is to cure the sick person, to cure the diseased person. Okay? So before that, we will understand what is meant by mission first. So the word mission means the purpose for which we are born. The mission is very important word. That is the only purpose we have born. So when we are becoming physician, what is our main purpose for which we are born? That is to cure the patient. This original mission word, it is a German word which is used by Hanuman. The meaning of that German word is Beruf, which means occupation, profession, vocation and calling. So Ari Tajan used this German word as a Beruf, and C.E. Miller, he used mission word as calling in various editions of Origin of Medicine. So mission, to accomplish that mission, there are some objects, steps, goals to which we are going to achieve our mission. So there should be some of the purpose, and one should have an object, then he can only achieve that. So let's understand by some of the examples that what is mean by mission. So whenever we are going to ask a priest, what is your mission? So within a fraction of a second, he will going to reply, my mission is the spread of religion, my religion, the spread of religious thought to the world. When we go through the history, when we are going to know what was the mission of the Mahatma Gandhi, Lokmanya Tilak. So immediately we got the answer, they always fought for the freedom of our country. What was the mission of the Sikandar? That to win the world. So these all are personalities, they were born only for that particular purpose. So again we are going to apply the same understanding here. The mission, Dr. Hanuman wanted to understand the mission of the physician, that is, he expects the homeopathic physician should work in the similar manner in order to achieve his goal, his mission, that is cure. He should achieve the cure. That is to cure patient, to cure the sick person. It is the only mission that every physician should have in his life. So let's move. So action speaks louder than words. Okay? So while practicing homeopathy, we should not forget that is the only mission. Instead of focusing materialistic attention, materialistic gain by practicing, that is to gain money or to understand, we should not focus on this materialistic thing. We should focus that is the cure of the patient. That is the only mission that we should follow. The most important word in this aphorism is to restore. To restore. It indicates that we should bring back to original healthy state from which an individual became sick. To restore. restore. That is the most important word in this aphorism, that we are again going to bring back that healthy vital force from the diseased state. Once the treatment is complete, the person should be restored to the original state of health. So that is the meaning of the word restore. To understand the sick terminology, we should know what is health, what is disease, then we can understand what is meant by cure. So this is the last part of this aphorism, but which is very important to know what is meant by sick. Before that, we should know what is meant by health, what is meant by disease. So health, according to the dictionary, it is the physical and mental well-being. We should be free from disease. These are the just understanding of the terminology health. But health is the normal functioning of the person, of the all functioning of the body. It is the normal functioning of vital force with the sensation of ease is health. And what is disease? It is the abnormal functioning of vital functions of the body with the sensation of uneasiness. So that is the main understanding of health and disease. Now we will go towards which is very important concept, that is sick, that every physician, every homeopathic physician should understand what is meant by sick. And it is the great understanding if we are going to open Dr. Kane's philosophy, lectures on Kane philosophy by Dr. J.T. Kane. In that first chapter, Dr. J.T. Kane had written and given explanation regarding the sick. Dr. Kane had said, there are only sick people. There is no disease. It is the man who is sick, not his parts. It is something prior, invisible, present inside, which gets sick, at first followed by the manifestation of the disease. So this is the new concept that we should understand what is meant by sick. So allopathic people, they are more focusing on finding the material cause of the disease. They are trying to find out what can be the cause which can be seen under the microscope. So why the spleen is enlarged, why this tumor is occurring. So they are more focusing on finding why this is occurring with the help of finding a material cause of the disease. But Dr. Hanneman, Dr. Kent, he said that first there is a prior invisible derangement of vital force is there. And that will going to create that disease condition in our body. So that's why the enlargement of spleen or the formation of tumor is the ultimates of the, or it is the result of the disease. This is not the cause of the disease. So that's why whenever we are understanding the terminology sick, it means it is the man who is sick, not his part. So simple example, whenever there is pain in our hand or leg or knee or head, we are not comfortable with the whole daily routine life. We may say, aaj kuch theek nahi lag raha hai. That means due to that particular disease part, as a person, as a whole, we are not feeling ease sensation. That means we are not well. So whenever we are sick, it is the man who is sick, not his spleen is sick, not his liver is sick, not his stomach is sick. The man who is whole as a sick. Now, which is very important, the last word of this aphorism, that is cure. So, Dr. Hanneman used this cure. Whenever whenever a patient gets a cure, there should be two conditions. First is the removal of perceptible signs and symptoms. Means the whatever the patient, he is having that symptoms, it should be removed totally. That is the removal of perceptible signs and symptoms. And second is, that is the vital force which has been primarily deranged, it has to be restored back again. That is the restoration of deranged vital force. Then only then we can say the person is cured. So healing is a synonym which means to make whole again. At a figurative level, it means to repair a breach in health. So the last important word in this aphorism is as it is termed. So the cure should be based on, first is the seven cardinal principles which has been quoted by Dr. Hahnemann, on which the whole homeopathy is based. So the cure should be based on seven cardinal principles. That is the law of simplex, law of similia, law of minimum, doctrine of drug dynamization, doctrine of drug proving, doctrine of vital force and doctrine of chronic disease. So accordingly, whenever the cure takes place, it should be as it is termed. That is the first point, seven cardinal principles. Second point, also in the direction of Haring's law of cure, which is given by Dr. Haring. So that law predicts us as that Haring's law should be in the following manner. That is, the cure should progresses, or cure should takes place from important organ to lesser organ, from within outwards, from above downwards, and in reverse order of appearance of the symptoms. So whenever the cure takes place, it should takes place according to the seven cardinal principles and the Haring's law of cure stated by Dr. Haring. Cure should takes place from within outwards. That is, from more important vital organ to the less important organ, it can be skin. It should be from above downwards. While having the cure, we should focus during follow-up, is our patient is having cure from above downward, that is from head to toe. And whenever the last point, that is in the reverse order of appearance of the symptoms, means when the patient gets the first symptom, that should be cure at the last. That is the reverse order of appearance of the symptoms, the cure should take place. So in a very brief manner, at least we have tried to understand the first aphorism, which is the basic and the beginning of Organon of Medicine. And we cannot understand this aphorism when we should not go immediately to the further aphorism, that is the second aphorism, which we are going to tell us about highest ideal of cure. So particularly for this lecture, we are going to stop here and we will move towards the second aphorism, that is highest ideal of cure, in the next class. Thank you.